Story we have followed from the very beginning, 15 days ago when it began, two inmates escape from a Lake County reentry program and go on a multi-state chase from here to Canyon City, Colorado. 24-hour News 8's Joe LaFurgey has been in Canyon City all weekend long and joins us now with more on his interview with one of the fugitives, Laura Grauman.
With the Colorado Rockies as the backdrop, it's easy to see why someone would want to hide out here. But it's doubtful that the Michigan fugitives called the Chamber of Commerce before picking Canyon, Colorado as their destination. Laura Grauman, one of two women who took part in the multi-state chase that started in West Michigan, sums up the reason for the series of events that ended in this Canyon City, Colorado motel. Meth, the dopamine-releasing drug that's given so many short-lived happiness only to hurt so many. Grauman talked about the drug her mother tried desperately to warn her about during our jailhouse interview in Canyon. Quote, tell her, I know she didn't raise me this way, and I'm sorry. Jail policy would not allow us to interview Grauman on camera. What you could not see, her face flush, her body twisting nervously as she sat behind the plexiglass separating inmates from visitors, often bursting into tears as she described, and what these pictures show, what the drug had done to her. The 29-year-old, currently held on a $2,000 bond on suspicion of conspiracy to commit aggravated motor vehicle theft, conspiracy to commit theft and possession of a controlled substance, traced the foursome's dramatic run from West Michigan cross-country. Grauman's interview helped answer several questions like, why Colorado? Why Canyon City? Turns out a friend of Grauman and her boyfriend, Greg Bradshaw, lived here. Grauman believed when they let the friend know they were coming, the friend called police. Something Grauman now says she actually appreciates. Grauman told us that even though she had the chance, she didn't run because she felt threatened by her cousin and boyfriend, telling 24-hour News 8, quote, I feel like if the cops hadn't caught us, I'd be going home in a body bag. Surrounded by mountains, even the low-rent motels in Canyon City have a room with a view. The budget host motel is no exception. This is where the fugitives set up shop, hiding out in a second-floor room and cooking the fuel their bodies craved. They set up a meth cooker in the bathtub, but local police were onto them.
And there was like eight police officers that were all stand up over here, and then the SWAT team pulled up around here.
The Canyon City police chief knew of the group's propensity to run from police in stolen vehicles and the risk that posed to the general public. So they put a small army of officers from all over the area together and waited until Ken Grauman and Greg Bradshaw were away from the car and their girlfriends, Laura Grauman and Brittany Rector.
Community safety here was a priority, and we made sure that we had enough resources to make this arrest in a very safe manner.
Once everyone was in handcuffs, police found the meth cooker along with a handgun, possibly the one stolen from a home near Door just days after the escape, although Laura Grauman denies breaking into that house. They also found cash, nearly $2,300. What they didn't find were the long guns and other weapons believed to be in the pickup truck they allegedly stole in Kokomo, Indiana. Where did they get the cash, and what did they do with the guns? Laura Grauman can't remember. The number of vehicles they stole and the things they took is still a blur. And there's not a lot of money in meth. Most people cook it for personal use. So where are the guns, and how did they get the money? Well, no proof yet, but police have a theory. They may have sold the guns. So, in a very unlikely place, the high desert town the locals call the climate capital of Colorado because of its moderate temperatures, the run was over for the foursome. But for at least one, Laura Grauman, the battle was only beginning. She needs to get off the meth. From her seat in the jail, she vowed this is it. No more meth. One can only hope that the 1,200-mile odyssey that so many people in West Michigan followed for 12 days will produce at least one positive result. It is very likely Laura Grauman could be the first to make it back home. Her bail is set at just $2,000. Ken Grauman II and Greg Bradshaw are being held without bail. Brittany Rector is being held in the Colorado juvenile court system. We'll keep you updated on all their cases. In Canyon, Colorado, Joe LaFurgey, 24-hour News 8.